I feel a lot better, and things are finally starting to come together in my little life. So the CDI setup and computer setup is still not what I want it to be. So right now, the sound is not what I want it to be, like microphone-wise, because eventually I'm gonna put the computer and everything in a smaller room where I can soundproof it. And right now I'm in kind of an echoey room, so can't stop production. And if I wait around until everything is perfect, it's never gonna get done. Shortly here, we're gonna start the Faces of Evil. I started it last week, but that was kind of like a, hey, let's get back into this stream. So we're gonna start it over from the beginning again. Legends, how are you? Sorry for the elevator music. I just grabbed the closest CD. I wanted something in the back so I could test, you know, make sure the microphone and levels were good. It may or may not come as a surprise, but it's playing on the CDI. If you didn't know this, the CDI could also be a CD player. So when you put a regular audio CD into it, you get this screen, and you can do that. Yeah. Hey, Lupus. We have the CDI fan. We have Omega Alpha here. Oh, okay. Got it. I got my special retro gaming magazine nearby, which Omega Alpha actually did an article in all about the CDI in it, which is really cool. I want to get it framed or something, make it look nice. What I really want to get my hands on, speaking of magazines, is the, you know, the CDI magazines that they used to put out? Those are kind of hard to come by. I remember having those as a kid, and I would love to have another one of those. They come up on eBay. I think someone posted one on eBay. I didn't think it was you. Suicide Snowman. Someone did. I saw it on Twitter. There was one. It was in the UK. Right now, I don't really have extra fundage to be, buying that sort of fun stuff. I got enough other things that I gotta get to and gotta get through. Yeah, they're really hard to come by. I swear that catalog or the CDI magazine, in my child memory, it was a catalog, but I think that was something else. What's CD32? Okay. really want to do? I want to get a, I want to get like a Windows 98 computer up and running so I can actually play those games. I have a lot of my old discs. I was just talking to my fiance about it the other day, Black and White. Black and White, that game, they made two of them. I never played the second one. But Black and White, the game where you played as a god, pardon me, and you could either be good or evil. I would love to revisit that game. I got the disc somewhere, but I, for the life of me, I cannot get it to load on a new Windows computer. I'm not real savvy with that sort of thing, so there might be a way to do it. Yeah, I might need to emulate it. But doesn't that seem kind of sad when I still have the original disc? I mean, I'm not one for being strict about playing the original disc only. As a lot of you know, most of my CDI collection these days is burned copies. Shh. Emulate older Windows. I don't know how to do that. I know how to like right click it and get it to run in Windows 98 mode or whatever, but that just didn't seem to get the job done. I got another weird old game too. It's called Hellbender. I don't know how well known it was. It came, a demo version of it came with some computer we got, and I liked it so much that we got the full Look, man, times are tough. I can't afford $500 Zelda discs. I still have my original Wand of Gamelon and Faces of Evil, but I lost my Zelda's Adventure, which is really sad. But then also not really sad because I did not know how to take care of discs when I was a kid, so almost all of my original discs are covered in scratches and full of glitchy bugginess. So, like my original Laser Lords disc, I had to replace it, and I did replace Laser Lords with a real disc. I did not get a copy. I would not forsake the name of Zendo and get a burned Laser Lords. That's not allowed. However, the original disc was scratched in just the right place where the claymation scenes, when you're flying between planets, a lot of them would freeze and crash the game, and it's just totally not playable. I had original Hotel Mario, but I was generous enough to give it to my sister when I sent her a 220 that myself and my father had refurbished for her, because she's the Hotel Mario nut. I am not. I am not good at Hotel Mario. I am really not good at it, but she's like expert wizard. So I let her have the original. I thought that was fair. We are gonna get going here soon. Hang on, gotta get up and switch these discs. Yeah, obscure games is a lot of fun. I like obscure everything. I never like doing anything that everybody's doing. Unless everybody was doing it 20 years ago. 20 years ago, it was only 2002. Atlantis, the CDI Atlantis game, that is... Did Stefan Pick the Peak? I don't know how you pronounce his name. Is he the guy who did the soundtrack for Lost Eden? Didn't he also do the soundtrack for Atlantis? Oh. I think we'll probably get started. And we can watch the cutscene. If the levels, any level seems poor, do let me know. I think the CDI is probably a little bit low, but I don't want to have it be too loud and you can't hear me. But I also don't want it to be... I don't want it to be too quiet that you can't hear it. I've not played Atlantis. I'm pretty sure he did the soundtrack for it. I know he did one for a Dune game, but that was not a CDI title. Yeah, Stefan Pick. Well, let's watch our favorite intro. Turn it up a little bit.
Gee, it sure is boring around here.
My boy, this peace is what all true warriors strive for.
I just wonder what Ganon's up to. Your Majesty, Ganon and his minions have seized the island of Korridai.
How can we help?
It is written, only Link can defeat Ganon.
Great, I'll grab my stuff.
There is no time. Your sword is enough.
How about a kiss? For luck.
You've got to be kidding.
Squadala, we are off.
Wow. What are all those heads?
These are the faces of evil. You must conquer each.
I guess I'd better get going.
Here is the map. Where do you wish to go?
All right, let's take it back down. I'm gonna let the overworld music play for a second while I talk, and I just want you all to tell me if the volumes sound good enough. Am I talking too loud? Am I talking too quiet? Is the music too loud? Is the music too quiet? Or is it just right? And Lupus, I'm sorry, you saw me do the same thing last week, but if you missed the very beginning, I'm starting it over again because last week was just kind of a... Music might be a little quiet. Okay. So we're gonna make it a little louder and see how that is. I don't hear the playback of my microphone. I'm watching the levels, but it's kind of hard to tell exactly what I'm... Yeah. I'm just gonna do this here, and if you want me to change it, let me know and I will. Alright, let me turn up a little more. See how that is. Now I'm not talking as much, which I don't want to be talking as much. Okay, cool. I will keep it at that. Thank you. Oh. Right now, all we're doing is just collecting snowballs. There's a lot of farming if you want to do this the right way. The hitboxes are the worst in this game. It's not that I'm a bad gamer. I mean, it is that I'm a bad gamer. But I'm not as bad as I seem. Ugh. Like there. I also think there's like a really, 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 really tiny delay. Ooh. Because of the unit that is converting the yellow, white, red cables into the computer. And that little tiny, that little tiny delay is enough to make it every now and then trip me up. But mostly it's just that my joystick sticks sometimes, the buttons don't work right quickly. Let's get these guys. After all that, and he's still punching me in the face. I kind of like to go through this twice, because that'll give me enough snowballs that if I mess up in Crater Cove, because I tend to mess up right at the end, then I have enough to go back through one more time. Like how delightfully intense the music is for this level. Like, it's one of the first levels, and it's just a little igloo place. I'm gonna run through it one more time. Sorry to bore you. Sticking. Or the button one is sticking. The music is really good. Keep it interesting. So then we're gonna go down a Oh, well, actually, no. First, we gotta buy some bombs. Ew, not a lot of money. I don't know what it's like to play this game for the first time, like, as an actual gamer. Because the first time I played it, I was a kid. So, I've been playing this game a really long time. It's just I've watched, like, Game Grumps. Oh, this is impossible. This is, what the hell? I can't watch it. I can't watch it because I see the obvious things they can do to avoid their frustration, but I can't tell them. I'm gonna run down here and grab these, green rubies. I need a couple of bombs, and you will know why when we get to Crater Cove. A lot of it is timing. Yeah, the really unforgiving thing about this game is that it's literally all just one painting, and there's no indication of what you should stand on. And what you can stand on. But I know it all! So we're gonna grab... What do we got here? 6 bombs. We can talk to the guy!
Lamp oil, rope, bombs? You want it? It's yours, my friend, as long as you have enough rubies.
More shoe, I think. I don't know. How did anybody figure out the name of, like, every character in this game? Nope. Yeah. Oops. That's what I needed the bombs for. It takes 10 hits to, kill them. I'm not getting involved with that key down there. It's not necessary. Yeah, but see, like what I was talking about, nothing here shows you that you can do this. But I know that you can do that.
It's a goma.
You're pretty good. Here.
Thanks.
Thanks. Now we got the pew-pews. And remember, this is only level 1 of the pew-pews. So when I take damage, like that, I lose it. Oh, that's not good. I think there's this... I don't want to waste my bombs! Ew. I think there's gonna be 2 more. I'm gonna restart this level. Well, should I? Oops. I did that. Yeah. Let me restart this level. I usually mess up at some point inside the cave. I decided to drink throat therapy tea for this stream instead of, like, beer that I normally do. Ugh. My throat's okay. It's just, you know. Ah! Talkies. lot of projectiles. And you really gotta watch them. Okay, so this is what we are getting snowballs for you playing along at home. Oh. And by killing these fire dyras, or whatever you want to call them, we get fire stones, thus completing the life cycle. They kind of have their own patterns to go on. Don't see, that's, it's either the little, that's why I go through Nortinka twice, because if not, I don't have enough, snowballs to finish this. That's why I don't go back and get the guy up there, and why I let them pass. Either I miss the rocks and fall in, or the little ones that are flying around hit me. The good news is, the ones that I get, the dyras that I kill, they do not regenerate on the same life. But we do need to watch. Those rocks. The rocks that pop up from the ground. We're not ready for there yet. First, we gotta go back here and complete the life cycle. Who do you all think the face of Nortinka is? Because there is no boss battle. To me, I think it's the guy up at the top on the hill. We're not dealing with her either. But we are gonna get our fire stones ready. And I don't mean our tires. I wanna get a, I wanna get all three of them in one go. Oh, hey. That's not looking good. The thing you gotta be careful for here is the icicles. Because you can't really see them. And you will take on damage like nobody's business. And you can't block them. Oh, see? Now there's abominable snowmen or whatever. Will not regenerate as well. Oh. I always have to go like heck up to the top. Oh, no. Once we're past the snow, I'm not going to get that one. I like that you can see Saragon Caves back there. I also really like the style of painting in general. I have not played The Apprentice.
I am the reader, Ipo. If you bring me the Book of Koridai, I will gladly read the secret verse.
I think they're just throwing rocks at you. I never really thought about it. I'm just gonna save real quick. I'm thinking here. I think we want to go Toy Cube Lighthouse. I think that's our next move. But I'm going to get a little more money. And get a little more stuff. Is Little Devil a scroller? I have not played that one. But I'm aware of it, and I feel like it might be. We'll come back to this level after Toy Q Lighthouse. I want some rope, just in case. And I want a few more bombs, just in case.
Lamp oil. Rope.
No, I did not. What the heck? No. Oh boy. Little devil. Little devil. No. If I get hit going up here, I'm doing this in two runs. I mean, maybe, I don't know. I tend to donk this one up too. Oh. We're not gonna bother talking to her. She's just gonna tell us that her husband is dead. Y'all probably know that, but in case y'all don't know, I ain't talking to any characters that are unnecessary to talk to. Unless they're really, really funny. And that character is not really, really funny. It's just kind of weird. We'll talk to her anyway in the end. I tend to mess up somewhere around here. All the jumping and the striking and the bump, 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 bump. Thanks for the spoiler. You're upset about getting spoiled on this game. Well, I feel sorry for you. Oh. I just want to get... Let me get in there. No. Oh, you bloody thing. This level shouldn't be that hard. Something else that's really hard for me. It's Harlequin. Harlequin, I usually have to do that a couple times. And Millitron too. Millitron kicks my ass. Maybe it's something I'm doing wrong. Get away. Let me just get in here. Thank you. Oh my god. It's our last life. Ooh. No. Do we stop to get them? We could risk... losing this whole level for 10 rubies.
It's mighty dark with all the evil about. Keep this lantern full. It'll light your way.
Thanks.
I like listening to him the second time, but I don't want to lose his... Yes, you stab people to talk to them. I mean, don't you? So now that we have the lantern, we can go through. Go, bro, new. I think. Well, I need to get some lamp oil. Every time I go to this level, I do this once just because it's smart. No! Gotta restart. I'm not starting that. Starting this level off with half a heart down. No, no, no. That's stupid. A weird level because the face on the map doesn't really look like Garonu. No, 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 no. Oh my god, it got stuck. This kill me. No, you know what we can do? I should go ahead and try to run through that and blow up that rock. Save me the trouble. Ugh. I'm not gonna be able to do it. All I gotta do is just get up there and Why didn't I let it kill me? Oh no. I gotta do all this again just to get the rock. Ugh. It's okay. I'll keep getting money. Oh no, I need that one. The red ones are just one. But the green ones are 5. And the blue ones, which we have yet to see, are 10. Which is pretty opposite from the rest of the Zelda universe. Alright, I'm gonna let this guy kill me. Like a loser. Just because that'll save me the, you know. Lessen the risk. God, that's sad. But see, look at this hat. Head and all that. It's not really how Garonu looks. Maybe it's how Garonu used to look. Oh, we could get pretty meta with that. Gotta let those guys hang out up there. There's pretty much two types of enemies in this game. There's the ones that are bent on attacking you, like the Arpicos, and they show up. They'll never leave you. No! Oh my god, I'm just going for it. Screw it. I'm really disappointed that I haven't been able to get this on the first go. But then there's other ones like the Daira that they just have a track that they run. And if you walk past them, they'll just keep going on their track. Oh, watch this.
Look and see Goronu.
Wake up, sleepy bones. Find the living and cut their vile throats.
Uh-oh. That's not good. And I wish I had the bell, but well. Alright. Gotta do this without losing that heart. Oh. Well. Not good. Are really hard to hit. Their hitboxes are like particularly nasty. Okay. Okay. Oh, what the heck? How did he do that? Now that just wasn't fair. Oh my god. Alright, last life. Now or never, guys. I swear, I'm worse when I'm live streaming. Like, when I know people are watching me play, I'm not as good as when I'm just, like, sitting around going, oh, whatever, I feel like CDI. This is it. Jump up there high enough to see him. Oh my gosh. I'm getting nervous. My palms are sweating. Also, as much as I love these backgrounds, and they are done really well, they don't make any frickin' sense. Because, like, the indentations behind us there look like it's the face, but we entered through the mouth. Oh no. Oh no, I died too.
You can't kill me.
Oh, crap.
No. No. No.
I died too. Oh, fuck. This happened. Oh my god. This happened when I fought Ganon the last time. I got all the way there. And I killed him, and I died. And with Ganon, it's worse, because that level's actually long. Like, come on. I need my bell. Oh, God. Man, I was hoping to get like halfway through this game in an hour. What the heck? It's not working out the way that I wanted it to. That's okay. Such fat synths. Such fat synths. Here's my bell. Yay. Part win. Oh, let me save this. All right. So not ready for Harlequin, but I am ready for Fearfish Falls. Let me think for a second. I got the bell, that's important. You need that. I need some more bombs. I got something really exciting to show you that I discovered recently at Glutco. I don't think we're gonna get that far in this stream. If we do, then that's awesome, but I don't think we will. We're doing pretty decent money-wise. So we'll get a good amount of bombs while we are here. Okay, so gonna go to Spearfish Falls. And then we'll go back to the lighthouse and then we'll tackle Harlequin, I think. For those of you playing along at home, the bell freezes any flying enemy for a little bit of time. Blue. Those are the blues that we're looking for. Dang! Those bombs have pretty good reach on them. I got both of those bats. Didn't realize they did that far. Come on. Not as hard as it looks.
You're doing great, Link. You're our hero. Here's a life heart. We know you can beat Ganon.
Yay! I love the painting around the cave. That style's in a lot of backgrounds in... Oop. Like... Come on, guys. Those things are not gonna... Oh my god. How did I mess that up? Oh, I thought you had to blow them up with bombs. You did. Rope to get out of here. Nope. I didn't think so. I give this level some extra credit because it has more than one, song that it plays. Come on. This is just wasting money. It's wasting me money! It costs money every time you use... Oh my god. Use the items like the bell. I don't care.
I may be old and ugly, but I still know a few tricks. Bring some grapple berries. I'll show you a good one.
I don't know if we want to see that. Okay. Thinking. Let's finish this part. Is there a benefit to Saragon Caves first? We'll miss a good cutscene with the crazy wizard if we do Saragon first. Oops, well, that didn't work out very well. We don't have to do the whole level, but, you know, we might as well.
How sweet. Mwah. My husband gave me this. He's an abominum now. Here. It's not much, but it'll still carry water.
Something I was watching, someone said, where did she get that bottle from and why did it make a noise? I'm pretty sure that noise is supposed to be her opening it. Probably not worth it to go through it all the way. It didn't work out well last time, so... Firestone Lake. Do I do that first? I really don't like Harlequin. I'm very bad at it. Firestone Lake. It's a pretty difficult level too. Oh wait, I need snowballs to do this. That's not good. Those Octorok are very, very tricky because it takes two hits to get them. And they throw rocks at you that are pretty low to the ground. So it can be hard to defend them. See that? Yeah, he keeps hitting me in the foot. So you really gotta stay one step ahead of them. If the same thing happens again, then I'm just gonna skip and go straight to Harlequin. See, there you go. Oh, I still have good spells. From here? No. Yeah, like this level actually takes a little bit of skill. We got some more fire dyros, and they're gonna be throwing their little hatchets at us, so that's okay. Wait a minute, do I have enough snowballs? I forgot. Alright. It's fun inside here. First, we get a really good cutscene.
What has happened?
In the darkest nightmare hour, when not moon nor sun has risen, I take Zelda in my power. I shall keep her in my prison.
Mm-hmm. So this part is really difficult because we have to lantern, we have to snowball because of these fucking things. And if they're, ay ay ay, especially precocious, we can use the bell. But then we gotta go between, oh fuck. I'm gonna need more damn snowballs. Or we can just keep using the bell. And just bell, 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 bell. How many do you think we can get behind us if we just keep using the bell? Only snowballs kill them. First, we're gonna grab these. Number one. Oh, we're gonna have to use this down here. That's actually... Damn, maybe that works out better. Fire diamond. Say, you have a fire diamond, don't you? We're not here yet, but we can go inside here. Good music in this level. Oh, up here. Oh, we gotta go all the way. Okay. It's okay. This level's pretty curious, because if you look at the map of Korodai, I actually want to make a whole video talking about the map of Korodai, because there's a lot to talk about. But it makes you wonder how a ship wrecked that high. We're going in here to talk to her.
My hero! Won't you please jump across that little old chasm and cut my daddy's chains? Pretty please? Have a heart.
And sadly, that is the last of the hearts that we can get. We can't do this yet, but the music is so good in this level. I think the paintings look kind of like heavy metal cover album covers. So we can just jump to our death. Check that out. That is some cool shit. Alright, last 10 minutes. We should get the... We should climb up through Spearfish Falls again so we can get her grapple berries. And then we'll tackle Harlequin. Oops. Fuck it. I don't even care. Wait, I do care. I gotta get all the way through the level. Oops. That's okay. Pretty sure if you don't jump over that stream after the little bridge, you will get donked. Here. No! Ah! Whoa. Man, piss off. Buzz off, scum mouth.
You're doing great.
Hey. It refilled my life. And refilled my bottle. Oh no. Oof. That's a little safer bet. All right.
Stir the berries in the tub. Let the juices soak the glove. Let Link fight and never cower. For his glove's a glove of power.
Wow, thanks.
Wow, thanks. God, the Link actor really is the worst. Okay. We're gonna try this until 4 o'clock. If we get it, we get it. If we don't, we'll get it next time.
See how Harlequin captures Corridians?
You lose.
Do you know what it means when you lose your last ruby? Now you work for me. Take him away.
So for everybody that played this game or saw that game and thought that that cutscene made literally no sense, because it literally makes no sense, I learned, and this goes back to the video I said I want to make about the whole map of Cordai, I learned from an article on The Cutting Room Floor, which is a really cool site that, talks about development information and secret stuff hidden on files in games. I learned that the original draft for Harlequin Bazaar was going to be a casino, which makes a whole lot more sense on context of that that cutscene. These big purple hand you are really hard to hit. And if they get at you the right way, they will just dun 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 dun. Come on. Good level to revisit when you need money. Which again makes sense if it was a casino. Not good. See you, Lupus. Thanks for coming by.
I'd say your chances are a million to none. But let's have fun anyway.
All right. I can bomb them. I can power glove them. Ugh. No, why did I do that? I'm not going to be able to get all the money. Oh my god, that was stupid. Oh, why did I do that? I get nervous in this level. I'm very bad at it. Do you actually have to hit him in the eye, or do you just have to hit him a few times? Oh, well that's why.
Lucky shot.
I think Millitron. Millitron has to be in the eye, and that's why it... Oof. We're gonna get this nice little chat, which is why I did not...
The star
stars are made of ice. Thus, the night is cold. Bring the crystal from Saragon, and I will prove the light of ice penetrates more than fire.
Man, this motherfucker up on top of this bazaar full of fucking pigmen, smoking some shit and talking some crazy ass nonsense. What the fuck? That's why we didn't do Saragon Caves first, because if we did Saragon Caves first, we would have missed that cutscene. It would have gone straight to getting the ice crystal. So we're going to go ahead and wrap up there. I think that's a pretty good stopping place. The plan when we come back, because Millitron actually does kick my ass, and it usually takes me a few times to do it. The plan's going to be knocking out that. Knocking out that once we get it. Knocking out Millitron, Glutko. That after Millitron, and then after that, I mean, I might be able to do this, and there's no way I can win this game in 2 hours. I'll probably have to do it over 3 streams. But we'll find out. So I thank everybody who came, everybody who watched it, and everybody who is watching it in the future. I was hoping I would have been able to get further if I did not have all those setbacks with Goronu. I probably would have been able to get further and been able to do it into two hours. But we'll find out. In case you don't already, make sure you follow me on Twitter or follow me on YouTube. You probably already do if you found me and you're watching this, but just in case you didn't, do that. I do have a Patreon. I don't really have anything good to give you yet, but I'm getting there, and one day I will. And when I do, I will tell you, and you will know it is time to subscribe. So I'll see you all later.